Hey everybody, thanks for being here. The nighttime is the right time, and this week it's a special episode where we're targeting rainbow trout at night on New Melones Reservoir. Now, if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. We're in the Sierra Nevada foothills just east of Stockton, California on New Melones Reservoir that's well known as a premier trout fishery. And in late summer, nighttime is the right time for rainbow trout.
That's shad. You can see like one couple fish in there. So basically this is like a ridge that comes over here, and then you throw your anchor on that side of it and it'll grab. And that way, then you just let the anchor rope out, because usually the wind's blowing in this direction, so you'll be right in the right spots. You see all the bait down there.
So it's at 82 degrees on the surface, and about 70 feet is the thermocline right around in there. So we go from 44 feet all the way down to 70. Catch right in there in the thermoclines.
So now, like, I got my anchor hooked, and see how I'm in this bowl right here. And you figure the rainbows will chase the bait into this bowl, and so it's a good ambushing area, and the trout just basically chase the bait into these dead ends. So we just set up right in front of this big bowl, and then we send our lights down, and we'll attract the bait, and then the rainbows will come. So this is one of my favorite spots, and well known for everybody that fishes out in New Melones. Okay, we have a three-way swivel, and I have one hook here on top. Okay, and it's really easy and click it. When you catch a fish on the top line, you just put it in the net, and you never bring the fish in the water, and you just do this, and then release the fish into the net, and then get this out of the way, because on the bottom line, I got about 10 feet. So when I send this down 40 feet, I'm really fishing 40 and 50 at the same time. So you can cover a lot of water columns that's this way. And it's just double the chance. And what I do is I put my weight right here onto this. And if I catch the fish on this one, it's the same thing. I just do the barrel swivel and then release the fish into the net and take it into the boat. Get the hook out, put it back on. So tonight we're gonna be, with the wind not being bad, I like doing about 2 ounces, get a straight down shot. So I grab a weight right out of here. 2 ounce weight. Just put it on here like this. And the barrel swivels could be big because they're not shy of it. Plus I got big fingers and it just makes it so much easier in the dark. And
whoops, I missed it.
Oh man, my eyes are like, I don't want to wear my glasses. Okay, so basically I put the weight on like this, close the snap, I bait up this with a night crawler and that end with a night crawler and some power bait, and basically put this in the water like that, just in like this. And basically, see how those, you gotta make sure this is not wrapped. So I just go around like this and boom, it's in the water. And I just follow it and let it fall evenly without the top wrapping around. Now it's down there and I go, okay, I wanna go 60. So I'm gonna be 60 and 70. So you really find the fish. So this is really good way to double your luck. And it's a deadly technique. So I'll show you how you guys bait up this now. And then I call it a rainbow hors d'oeuvre. Okay. Okay, basically, I first put a power nugget on and I slide it up like this. Then I got a whole night crawler because you're fishing with, you're going after big rainbows, so you know you don't want to go small. Don't worry, they'll eat it, even the small ones will. So I run the threader all the way up to its body. See all that juice coming out? That's like live bait, blood, and trout can't resist it. So basically, thread the worm on like this.
run it all the way up, and I go past the hook. Slide this down a little bit, then I grab another nugget. Run the hook in. Bring up above the hook. Bring the night crawler down, and I bring this one down. Now you got this. I just bring a little bit like that. Okay. And now I get a power bait and I mold it into a teardrop. And this is a key to any bank fishing, power bait people, and everything. This is what I love, okay? You got all the residue on your fingers. Don't wipe it on your pants or on a rag. I get the residue and I clean my fingers off, and I go all the way up the leader with power bait. So basically, when you drop it down, the power bait will melt off. Basically, you just get this cheesy trail, and the trout will just zone in on it, and it'll just come to the hors d'oeuvre. And this is a rainbow hors d'oeuvre, and I'm telling you, I can't resist it.
Back to the gold country of California and New Melones Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. Nightfall is coming fast, and we're set up for nighttime rainbows with Richard Kowski and Frank Cecena.
You can see we're getting a bite. You know, the fish is just gobbling that hors d'oeuvre down. So basically, I usually just take it out of the rod holder and just kind of get the clicker off. And then you just start feeling them. And when they start swimming away, I can just feel them munching on it. I'm feeling right now. Come on, baby. Must be a small one.
You go.
That's something. Usually they just must be a small one. Got him. Nothing there. And, yep, got the bottom hook. Okay, we'll try it again.
Okay, let's try 47.
So you're going to be at 47 and yep. 57.
Yep.
I just love this kind of fishing. It's like, you know, you bring out good food and you got your buddies with you and you just laugh and joke, and it's just such a great environment. You know, you got no waves and jet skiers. You know how ski season goes, and it's just a peaceful way of fishing and just hanging out with your buddies.
Clicker off.
Clicker.
Okay, we're on.
It has a little bit of shoulders. Nah.
Is that crazy?
Again?
This is funny, Frankie. We'll get there. I'm just gonna let it eat it. And let it just take it. Once it starts swimming away like it is, it's boom. There we go, fish on.
No way.
It's gone. Is that crazy? Gotta be a small one messing with us. Yeah, right here is like we insert this glow stick, so when it gets pitch dark at night, you got not only have the bell, you can see the light, and there's a great indicator. And these holders are nice because you just plug the glow stick right into them. Open them up and clamp them right under the pole. Okay, we look like we're getting a bite here a minute ago. Come on, baby, come back. Yeah,
they, oh yeah, he's on there now.
Fish?
Yeah. I don't think it's very big though. One in the box. Right here is a basically the smaller size. It looks about a, let me look at it. It looks about like a 2 pounder, a solid 2 pounder, but we can get them all the way up to 10 pounds at times. But these are really good eating. The meat's orange is red, and boy, I just love eating rainbow tacos. I've just been hooked on those lately. So what we do, we don't bring the fish in the boat. We just do this barrel swivel, and at least leave the fish in the net, and then just get the lines out of the way, and then bring the fish in. Basically, there's a beautiful trout right here. That's about the smallest they come, and then they work their way up to 10 pounds, but this is really good eating. We usually just keep them all because basically they swallow the hook, and they're gonna die, so basically we just eat them. There we go.
It's a pitch black night on New Melones Reservoir, and we're anchored up with Richard Kowski and Frank Cecena for great eating rainbow trout.
And the most important thing to do is always keep your fish on ice. You just can't beat the freshness of a fish when it's stored in crushed ice. Okay, we're gonna send down the fish hawk right now and check the temperature. We're gonna drop it all the way to the bottom, and then we're gonna bring it back up and see the reading. This is a very helpful tool. Okay. Okay, we got view right here, so we'll start off right now. Okay, the surface is 81.2. Okay, 5 feet down, it's 81.1. 10 feet down, 81.1. 80.9 at 15 feet. 80.5 at 20 feet. 79.2 at 25 feet. 76.8 at 30, 73.0, 35 feet, 69.9 at 40 feet, 66.9 at 45 feet, 64.4 at 50 feet, 62.0 at 55 feet, 59.6 at 60 feet, 57.6 at 55 feet. Now this is where we're getting in, where rainbows like to be, is like in the 57, 54 to 56 range. Okay, there we go, 56.0 at 70 feet. That's basically where ideal for a rainbow to be. 55.3 at 75 feet. Now 54.8 for 90 feet. Now this is kokanee temperatures. 54.2 at 90, 53.9 at 95 feet, 53.6 at 100 feet, 53.6 at 105. Like you see that right there is the steady thermocline. It's not really dropping or that much now. It's like in the 53.6 range. So basically you got a good thermocline right there. So that's where basically if you're trolling for kokanee, that's where they'll be. 53.35 at 110 and back to the surface. This tool is just awesome.
Okay, we got a bite here going on. You're gone there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he's loaded.
Oh yeah, it's a nice one. It has a little bit of shoulders, I think. That's coming up. What's in there? Nice trout.
Little guy?
Well, that's not bad. It's about 3-pounder, maybe. Maybe 2.5.
One in there, you're good. I'll take the first.
Right. That's what we're looking for. See how clean these fish look? You know, no sores and just a beautiful rainbow. Nice big tail. It's a healthy, healthy fish.
Hey everybody, I hope you're enjoying this week's episode where we're doing some night fishing for trout. Now we're with Richard Kowski, who's well known in Northern California for catching big fish while trolling. But tonight, we're bait fishing for fish that we want to eat. It's not about catching trophies, it's about catching quality trout. Now bait fishing is all about scent. And you know what's better than a lot of scent? Even more scent. I'm going to show you quickly how you can add even more scent to this type of presentation with a night crawler. So you've got your night crawler, we'll say it's on your hook already, and we're just gonna take this Procure bait injection system, which is a bottle with a kind of a horse needle on it, big needle. Now you take this, you can fill it with whatever scent you like. I like anise plus for trout. They like that sweetness of the anise or the anise. And there's also some other great fish oils in here, but it's whatever scent you prefer. And another one that I really like for trout is my original formula, Scent Chamber Magic, which has sardine and krill, which is awesome for trout. But anyway, it's very simple. You're just going to fill this with whatever scent you want, or you can get the caps. Procure sells them, and we have them in the shop here in 3-packs, and you can just put the cap right on whatever bottle you have, and you're ready to go. So you're just going to fill this, put it in the worm as far as you can, and as you're pulling it out, just squeeze, and that will fill that body cavity full of scent that's just going to ooze out and make a huge cloud of scent that's going to maybe induce a feeding frenzy. So it's pretty simple. A lot like the concept of a worm blower, where you're injecting air into a worm to make it float. But in this case, we're just injecting good oils that are going to bring the fish to the bait and make them bite. Now, we're looking for limits of some great eating fish on New Melones. It's the middle of the night, and we got more work to do.
Nice, beautiful. Bring them back up again. Slow. Oh, yeah, big rainbow. Big rainbow. That's what we're looking for. Oh, that's
a
nice one.
Yeah, it's a pretty one.
Yeah, that's a pretty
Disconnect
one.
Disconnect that leader.
Okay. Nice. Oops. Oh, yeah.
That's at least six
pounds.
About 5-6, huh?
Yeah. Oh, it's beautiful. Look at the tail on him.
Nice clean fish.
Nice clean fish. On the fish hawk, you see that we took a reading and everything, and we found that the ultimate depth was 60 to 70 feet. And they're in the 58 to 56 degrees, and that's where you find the big rainbows.
Right, after finding out that the water was a little cooler down below, we went down to 60 feet, and this is the results right here.
Cool. Fish on, Frankie?
I think so.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
All right. Yeah, let's freshen this thing up.
Crawler?
Yeah, it's got a nice brand new crawler on there. Get this thing cleaned up. It's very important to change your bait. Probably I like changing it maybe every half an hour to 40 minutes.
Okay, got him. Oh, you feel like you did one? Oh, yeah, nice one.
Little camp fryer. Take the leader off him?
Yeah, I'll take the leader off to it.
Fish on, he's right here.
Oh, yeah.
All right, man, we got 9 in the box. One more and we're limited.
Look at this nice catfish.
Okay, we're just gonna let this guy go.
Here you go, guys. Thanks for the fight.
There
you go.
All right, number 10.
Hey, thanks for making the time to watch today's episode, and I hope it was time well spent. Now, if we can help you out with your own fishing, be sure to stop into the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. And remember, without our sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.